As far as the menu for this second hour is concerned, Namibian musician Sean Kamati has made it to the electrifying stage of X Factor Malta Season 4. Sean will join us virtually all the way from Malta to talk to us about this very exciting journey, the experiences, as well as the challenges. To provide information on the additional benefits of student stay and to explain what student stay is all about, we'll also be joined by Jean-Marc Madui, the Managing Director at Student Stay. And then we'll cross over to the Namibian coast to join NBC reporter Stefan Urap, who's standing by with Justina Mukwaya, the founder of Miss Teen Mondesa, to tell us more about those exciting developments. The second hour promising to burst at the seams with wholeness and greatness. Don't go anywhere.
Sean Kamati u Christy minna u nixtiqilkom l-ikbar good luck li qatt eżistit fid-dinja. Sean Kamati.
Never meant to cause you any pain. I only went on one time to see you laughing. I only want to see you laughing. Purple rain, purple rain.
Well, that, of course, was Namibian musician Sean Kamati, who has made it to the electrifying stage of X Factor Malta Season 4, where talent knows no bounds and dreams take flight. Sean now joins us virtually all the way from Malta to share with us all the excitement. Good morning, Sean, and welcome to Good Morning Namibia.
Good morning. How are you doing?
I'm doing well, thank you. There cannot be any iota of doubt, Sean, that there's no one like Sean Kamati. That was so amazing to witness and to see. How are you doing?
I'm doing very well. I'm doing really, really well. It's an exciting time in my life. It's an exciting journey. And I'm sort of grabbing the bull by the horns and going with it. So I'm good.
The proof of the pudding lies in the eating, and you're certainly feasting. For those few Namibians, for those viewers tuned in from across the globe on the NBC Plus app who may not yet be familiar with Sean Kamati, please tell them a bit about yourself.
Well, as we know, I'm Sean Kamati, and I am born and raised in Windhoek, Namibia. I'm a musician. I started singing quite a while back, and I started singing on the song night stage. And that's where I really honed my craft, you know, and from there managed to push it forward, started releasing music, and I've done quite a few things. I've been performing in South Africa, in the UK, in Namibia as well, opened up for Joss Stone and Lyra. I've performed with many great Namibian artists. And yeah, so now I'm trying to bring Namibia to the world.
You're doing a fantastic job of that. The craft has, of course, been honed. Tell us more about what took you to Malta, if that is in the public domain or you so wish to put it in the public domain, but also, and more importantly, about X Factor.
So, yeah, I mean, I arrived in Malta. I left Namibia 2020 to the UK, and that was literally in the middle of COVID. And I got another opportunity to move to Malta, and I took it. Moved to Malta, sort of started setting up roots here and started performing, started gigging, you know, got myself out there. It's a very small island, so everyone knows everyone. And eventually, I think it was last year, February, that I was contacted by Instagram by one of the producers of X Factor Malta. I'm sure, I think they have seen some of my videos or whatever. And they invited me to audition, and I did that. And here we are. Now I'm on the live shows.
That's a very big deal. How has the experience been for you thus far?
The experience has been great. It's been a real learning curve about the industry and about TV, for example, because it's performing for TV or on TV is completely different from just doing like a gig. You know, I've learned a lot from my mentor. I've learned how to, you know, see things differently as an artist, take outside, how do I say, advice and criticism. And criticism in this sense is not negative, to sort of perfect my craft. And it's been great because I have been accepted so well by the local community, and that's really been a plus for me.
Have you encountered any challenges? And if yes, how have you dealt with those?
Challenges in the journey so far, not really, apart from the fact that it's a lot of work. You know, what you see on TV is really just 2% of what happens backstage. The only thing that might not work in my favor, but also, is the fact that I'm not Maltese. And because it's so small here, you know, people, it's a contest, and yes, it's a talent contest, but it's also people, you know, vote for who they know. However, I'm still here, so there is definitely still a chance for me to make it further.
Absolutely. You've spoken earlier about the wonderful collaborations. You've collaborated with both local and international artists. Would you say that there is an artist, or that there are artists, who influenced your approach to your craft?
Oh, most definitely. I mean, if we have to think on a wider scale, I'm very much influenced by Motown, you know, old school music from Stevie Wonder, Ray Charles, Prince, Aretha, you know, and that's really where I have sort of directed myself as an artist. And I mean, I do look up to many artists, even our local artists, Lisa Ellis, Gaza, Lady May. You know, those are people in the Namibian industry that work hard and that have worked hard, you know, to get themselves out there and to get themselves known and to sort of cement themselves as, you know, Namibian artists. Even artists like Jackson Kayewa, Rashihama. Those are really big inspirations for me as well.
I'm sure they're happy, and hopefully they tune in. Talk to us about how you prepare in general for a gig, but certainly also for competitions of this nature. Is there any honey involved, any lemon, any ginger, any garlic, hot water?
There there's a lot of vocal exercises, a lot of honey, hot water, ginger, lemon, sometimes even garlic. But then also just rest, really, because you don't want to be tired. You don't want your voice to be tired. Sometimes you also just need to like keep quiet, you know, for a while before you gig, and that really does help. But
do you struggle to keep quiet?
Not really. Not really. I mean, I am a talkative person, but when I'm preparing, I kind of keep to myself. I also have to center myself, focus, meditate, pray, you know, just get myself grounded and focused and prepared for what I'm about to do.
What has your experience been specifically with the diverse panel of judges?
So the judges here are all local, heavyweights in the industry. For instance, my mentor is one of the biggest like artist managers and producers here in Malta, which is a great thing because he also understands the industry and like the business of music. You know, most of all the other three, there are four judges. My mentor is a producer, and then the other three are all singers. So, you know, I've sort of learned to see what they do and to see how they capture the audience here, sort of to make my own, you know, my own way. I've already done my own thing, really, and it's been quite successful so far, but it doesn't hurt to learn.
Absolutely not. Sean, whichever way this goes, what do you believe this will do for your career, for your journey in any case?
This opportunity, and I see it as an opportunity, is I think it came at the right time for me. You know, sometimes one might think it's too late or you're too old or whatever. But this for me is definitely a big stepping stone onto a different new audience and a wider platform. Because yes, I am here in in Malta, and it's also part of Europe, so I can start here and go further and just kind of build my way across to reach a wider audience. So I'm definitely, like I said before, grabbing this opportunity by the horns so that the world can hear about Sean Kamati.
Sean, thank you so much for your time. Good luck with the rest of the competition. We are super proud of you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Renowned Namibian musician Sean Kamati talking to us all the way from Malta about X Factor Season 4 Malta that he's participating in. We will be back.